What's up, kings and queens? It's your girl QTP, and welcome back to the Queen Palace with a quick update about Mr. Businessman. So, even though I post those videos, we had actually been, you know, communicating, vibing consistently every day. Good morning text. I felt comfortable initiating text. It was a vibe. And one day he said, you know what, I think it's time that we meet. And I said, sure. The big girl is coming to him truthful and direct. So I casually sent him some pictures of me full body so he see exactly what he getting. He was fine. And he said, you know, let's grab a burger and some fries. Arby's, the meats. I said, I like their brisket. He said, I ain't never had it, but I'll have it tomorrow. And I'm thinking, he could be joking or he could be testing me. If you want to get a burger, though, and some fries just for the initial meetup, whatever. But he said he was just joking. And he said, I actually made reservations for us. Ha, ha, ha. Cool. I was excited. I was nervous. I told my mom and some close friends, and how did I feel? I just felt ready because usually after a couple of days or a week, the guys fall off. I ain't gonna lie to you. Like the conversation, I don't be moved. It's just pointless conversation, but we have been laughing and talking, and I feel safe, you know, within limits, you know. I felt good about this one. So, the background is, he was previously married, and his divorce was, he said, 10 years ago, and he has a daughter that's 9, and he told me that he had been with his daughter a little bit after, you know, she was born. He was present. They tried to make it work. They had therapy and it just didn't work out. They grew apart. And as a result, they got their divorce. And he had another woman in his life about 2 years ago. They were together for 2 years, I think he said. And she had some, I'll say, some issues that she had to, you know, work out. And once he realized it was more than what he could handle, he left, which I do understand why he left. So he made reservations. All Saturday, I was just like nervous, excited. I want to figure out what to wear, which wig to wear, what color to wear. I chose a royal blue shirt. I really like that shirt because it's a long fitted. And I wore this wig, you know, a little blue eyeshadow, and she was really cute. Okay, so I parked. I'm not that girl that pays for parking like that. I'd rather go to places where I don't have to worry about parking, honestly. But I called the restaurant and I asked them, how is parking in their area? And they said, I ain't gonna lie to you, it's like 2 rows, limited spaces, so you might have to pay for parking. So I pulled up, I paid for parking because I don't got time to be looking around. Plus, he might be in his car watching me. I'm gonna look stupid. You know, I be in my head. I'm not crazy, but I do think I have a little bit of anxiety. Like, it can go, and I have PCOS, which I did read. You know, you could have anxiety. But I only have it within reason. Like, I'm not just tripping out. Like, some folks can just be, you know, at work and just, that's not me. If I have anxiety, I'm feeling a little anxious, someone has done something and I'm waiting on them and I'm just not in control. So I think my anxiety can be pretty regular level. Like if I like you and we're talking and I text you at 12 and I don't hear anything 1, 2, 3, 4 p.m., 5 p.m., 6 p.m., I'm wondering, are you okay? Are you ignoring me? Because I would think if we on that level, you would shoot me a text, just say, hey. So anyway, I told him that, and he was beginning to like say, hey, babe, you know, I have a meeting I'm going to, or I'm going to be away, so you won't hear from me for a little while, just so I know what's going on. And I love that. So anyway, I'm like, this might be a keeper. This might be. Oh, did my wig just go off? Child. This might. It is hot. That's why, because it was hot. That's all. This might be something promising. So anyway, got to the place, paid for parking. It said, thank you for your payment. It said that it expires on Sunday at 5:20 or 5:30. I waited. I looked down. I saw that there was some white paper there. I got my receipt. It said receipt, preferred parking. No lot number, nothing. I put it on my dashboard and went inside the restaurant.
I wanted to share the rest of my life with you. You're reaching out to me, so I'm reaching out to you. Rate, comment, subscribe, watch my videos. QTP, yes, that's me.
He was not there yet. I was sweating. I took some deep breaths because I did not want him to come in. I'm just like sweating like this. So I just like, okay, calm down. Got myself together. Sweating bullets. Here. And he was like, hey, you know, I'm like 5 minutes away. I said, take your time. And I got myself together. He said, I'm here. Where are you? I said, I'm inside. He walked in. He was dressed like very casual. I was like more like dressed up. But he was still cute. He went like the wrong way. But he looked around to see if he saw me. And I'm glad that he could tell it was me. And like, who is this? I was like. And he came. He sat down. No, I got up, I hugged him, you know, and we just talked, and I was smiling and blushing, and he was smiling and pleasant, great conversation, he's super chill, even though I'm very animated, I'm also very chill. I be in my head sometimes, but I'm very chill. To a certain extent, but it went well. Now, I wanted to use this time to talk to him, to laugh. We talked about businesses, we talked about social media, we talked about some things that we have been talking about, what he think about me, and he said, you know what, I take you for face value. So far, I think you're very genuine, cool people, nice vibe. I like your energy. Now, I did notice that he is super positive like me, super like my peaceful bubble, and that's beautiful. But I saw somewhere that he was with his wife in 2017, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. We're now in 22. That's 5 years. But mind you, he said his divorce was 10 years ago. I've really been trying to get to know guys, and unfortunately, the dating scene has been packed with liars. I've had guys, you know, be all in towards me, and they're married. I've had guys, oh, I really like you. I want to be with you. And I found out that they have a child that they never told me about. I've had guys who approached me, seemed so into me, and I found out that they actually would also entertain a guy if he had a wig on. So it's just been a lot. Or it's possible that they never got a divorce and they're separated. Then so during our dinner, he casually mentioned his last name. I already knew his last name, but I let him mention it. And so he calls me, you know, Officer in my first name. Let's just say QTP. Officer QTP, because he sees that I... you can't just tell me anything. And so I said, so I sent him a screenshot or something. And he noticed something in the screenshot that was not what we talked about. And so I said, investigator in his last name. And he said, how you know my last name? And I said, because you told me during dinner. And he sent me a GIF like, And he said, right. And he said, it's odd that you scorched the earth to find my divorce date. With a mind blown emoji. And he was like, spooky. And I was like, spooky? Nah. Because, like, spooky to me means, like, scary. You doing too much. And he was like, 1,000%. Now, I've had someone I've called. And when I called them, they knew me as the Queen Palace. And when I called them using my personal phone number, they said my first and last name when they called me back, because that they have this app and it identifies you. And I didn't like that. I felt weird. I felt violated. I felt like, what you doing? Like, why are you doing that? You know? And so I felt like he felt like I felt at that moment a little violated, a little rubbed wrong, like my privacy isn't private anymore. And I said, sweetie, you know, you told me your last name. You mentioned your last name a few times during dinner, because he was mocking what his coworkers say, and they call him by his last name. And I guess he forgot. So he said, oh, Shawty, you know, I think you took it wrong. And I said, oh, okay, well, you know, call me whatever. The texting got different. It was no more boo. He wasn't calling me boo no more. He wasn't checking in on me throughout the day no more. And the next day, it was crickets. Like, nothing. 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 And I'm like, he is wrong. Like, and so he jokes a lot, right? And so he also made a comment, I won't joke with you no more. Y'all, I'm a jokester. I love to laugh, crack jokes. I love that. However, I don't like it when someone really feels away. And I'm a communicator. Let's talk. I want you to acknowledge what I'm saying. I hear you out. And we move on. I can move on. But he never called me when I did request it. I said, I want to talk to you on the phone. He didn't call. I called him. Last time I called him, he called me right back. This time he texted me. Hey, I was on the phone. What's up? I said, well, call me when you get a chance. He didn't call. So the next day, I'm like, the ball is in your court. I have requested you to call me and you didn't do so. And he did tell me jokingly, but again, seriously, he wants me to initiate more contact. I say good morning. I ask how he's doing throughout the day, but I need you to also give me that same thing. But I need to feel comfortable. I've had guys in the past act like I'm sweating them or I'm on them. And so if that's what you're into, you want me to text you, give me some grace. You know, allow me to feel comfortable and I'll do it. I felt really comfortable last week just texting him throughout the day. He would respond pretty quickly. I felt like he was all in. And this week, it has been wiped away. It is like homie town. And so one day this week, I forgot the date, honestly, or the day. Didn't text him because he didn't text me. And I asked you to call me. The next day, I get a text. top of the morning, how are you? Haven't heard from you ever since yesterday around da 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 time, 8 in the morning. I said, I was thinking the same thing. So then he posts online about communication. If you want to call someone, call them. If you miss them, tell them. Like, you talking about me? He wants me to initiate. I have no problem. However, I feel like we had a little moment here where I'm feeling a little uneasy. If you want me to potentially be your next boo, and we're working on building, call your girl so we can talk. Just call me. Yes, we've seen audio clips, but I want to talk to you. So then, yesterday, I felt a little better. He said he heard my audio. I said, I miss you. You be on my mind. He didn't say it back, though. He was just like, yeah, I heard your audio. I think there's a disconnect. And I'll course react, something. I looked it up. It means when there's a problem, you fix it. So I'm thinking, okay, we're going to fix it. We're going to communicate. You're going to call me. We're going to talk and move forward. And it's back to, hey, boo, shorty, or hey, boo, and let's hang out. Nothing. I went to sleep last night, y'all. I'm thinking when I wake up, my phone, I'm going to get texts. He used to always text me, daughter. It's not the same. Nothing. Phone dry. So, again, if y'all don't know me, QTP do not like to sweat because I've been sweated. I've had people act like I'm sweating. I'm like, I'm just reaching out. So, again, some folks love that. And he told me he do. So, I said, you know what? This not me, but I'm going to go out my way and call him. I called him last night around like 8:40. Nothing. So, I formed a text message going in. Respectfully going in, but going in. You say you want this from me. You say you don't have expectations. But then he said he would have liked it if I had not just sat down in that restaurant. He would have liked to have came to me and walked in with me. So, that is an expectation. And then you saying you want me to hit you up more. You expect that. You are requesting that from me. So you act like, oh, I'm chilling. I'm super calm. I'm this, I'm that. No, you have feelings. And I have feelings. And my thing is, this is my first, or would have been my first adult boyfriend if we made it to that level. But he seems so positive. And my thing is, with positivity, let's address things and move on. But we never talked about it. We said some audio clips. And he said, oh, no, boo, but I want to talk to you in real time. So anyway, yesterday I said, you know what? Let's talk on the phone or let's meet in person. No response to that. I called him last night as well. No response. So last night I said, you know what? I want to make this long text. I said, you know what? Let me stop. Let me not do that because he might reach out to me. I text him good morning. Usually I get a good morning text 7, 8. I text him. I said, good morning. Have a great day or something. 8, no response. 9, no response. 10, no response. 11, no response. 12, something. Top of the morning, I'm in the office today. Have a great day. How was your meeting? Because I told him I had a meeting. But I played it off yesterday. I said, well, just call me so I can tell you about my meeting. No call. He said if he felt the way, he would tell me. We had that conversation during dinner. Like, nah, if I felt the way, I would tell you. He's not saying that. He's just acting different. And he said, there's a disconnect on his intent and he will course correct. That's what he said. Course correct. And I'm thinking, you're going to fix it, but could that mean I'm just going to fall back? Like, that's how I'm going to fix it. But still tell me that, you know? And I remember I said, sometimes you meet someone online and y'all just stop talking. He was like, stop talking? What kind of guys have you been talking to? Like, he act like he's so different and so positive. And I just feel like I've tried. And the first week and the second week of us getting to know each other, I felt comfortable hitting him up first. And it's just now, because I feel distant, I'm not getting my calls answered, I'm not getting my texts answered, I feel like, well, why should I keep trying, you know? And so I talked to my male friends and they were just like, you know, just let him hit you up, which of course, and he did today, but it's still not the same. And it's like, you mad at me because I asked you about when was your divorce date? Your divorce date, you said was 10 years ago, and it was really like 4 or 5 years ago if you were divorced. You could really be separated and not have trouble because his ex-wife was in the military, and he said they got married because benefits. He just really liked her at that time. You know, whatever. I'm not going, you know, into that, but y'all, it's a lot. He asked me, what is your love language? I think, I don't know what I said, but it's definitely, I would think, words of affirmation. I don't think he's a bad guy. But here is the play, right? He says, you know, at night after 9, I disconnect. I put my phone up. I watch the game, or I'm watching educational stuff. I'm learning about stocks. So he act like he be chilling. He's peaceful. He be home. And I love that because I be at home. I be chilling in peace. And I don't want a man that's ripping and running the streets. Now he do go out for work because he's a businessman. I'm hurt a little bit. Yesterday I was just like, oh my gosh, she's not here anymore in my life. I think he's not comfortable having conversations. And again, I joke with you, but I can also be serious with you. And when I do so, I need you to hear me. I need you to feel me. I didn't say nothing crazy. I was so polite, so calm, but I clearly articulated how I felt. He said, Charlotte, I think you misread what I was saying. And then if that's the case, why not say, nah, it wasn't that, and we move on. But also call me because I want to hear you in real time. So that's that. After the date, he said, let me walk you to your car. I said, oh, no, you don't have to. But he said, oh, no. I like that. I go inside the parking lot, and I'm clicking my car button, and I don't see my car. I'm clicking it like, is my sense of direction off? Like, am I just nervous? My car should be here in front of the kiosk. It's not there. And then it dawned on me, someone stole my car, or my car was towed. And my car was towed. I called the place on the pole. They said, yeah, we have your car. You did not pay. Remember I said, it said, thanks for your payment and let me know when it expires. I checked my bank card, or like my bank statement. It was pending. It was pending Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Today it's not on my account anymore. I believe the kiosk was messed up. This was Preferred Parking on Brevard Street, Charlotte, North Carolina. I believe the kiosk machine was messed up. My receipt was pretty much blank. All it said was Preferred Parking, and it said receipt. It didn't have my lot number, and I didn't think anything because that's what they gave me. And I saw, thanks for your payment. So I request a refund. They said no. They said, we do not see that you made payment. I sent them a picture, a screenshot of it pending, and they said that do not mean that it was posted. And so that's where we are. It was denied. And guess how much? Okay, so the parking was $13. The toll was $395.66 or 55 cents. Now, what I will say is that Buddy was saying that the girls in the past, his other two dates, whatever, I'm his third date, he said they were gold diggers. And one girl, like, she just stayed on her phone the whole time. And I didn't do that. And, like, I want a man that got money, of course. But we don't talk about that. Like, it's about, like, cool vibes. Do I regret calling him Mr. Williams? No, because he told me his last name and he forgot. Oh, and his clips that he sent me, his audio clips, his location has been on there. So every time he'll say, oh, I'm here, he's been there. He hasn't been lying. And then at dinner, he said, oh, yeah, I realized that my location is on my audio clips. And I know you saw that too. And I was like, huh? Oh, no, I feel like the truth is, if I was not QTP and my friend, I said, girl, you have went above and beyond. Let him call you. How am I supposed to know you not mad when you saying I'm spooky? You don't put LOL. You don't put JK. I won't. He not doing it. He want to joke. Don't do that. Like, again, if you my man and you got an issue with me, like, yo, That wig. If you don't want me wearing a wig, just say, babe, I really like you. I think you're beautiful. I really don't like it when you wear wigs. Like, be direct. Be clear. Like, I don't. It's hard for me to operate having to guess and wonder. And on Mother's Day in the morning, he said, oh, yeah, I'm getting up. I'm going to have some coffee and just relax or something, right? Later that day, on Saturday, Mother's Day weekend, he said he going to church tomorrow. I said, oh, because he said to me, he ain't going to be going to church with me all the time. He'll go sometimes, but not all the time. I said, oh, you going to church? He said, oh, yeah, with his mom. His mom lives in Georgia. So I'm like, he said, oh, babe, I thought I told you I'm in Georgia. You didn't tell me you was going to Georgia. Oh, I thought you knew. I didn't know what you. Yo, I've been single for so long. I have to get used to just, like, letting you know stuff. So I'm trying to be understanding. That rubbed me wrong. But he apologized. I said, you know what? Let's just move forward. So my thing is, if I have a question about your divorce date, because you said 10 years ago, and it was not 10 years ago, why are you so quick to keep cracking jokes on me, expressing how you feel? I'm an investigator. Yes, I am an investigator. QTP investigator. What's up? I catch that lie every day, all day when I need to, and you're sounding a little suspicious, What's up? You acting funny now. I think I got on them heels. I think I got on them heels a little too close. And he said, oh, I got to go. Because unfortunately, you know, I've just been lied to. A lot. I've been conditioned to just keep my ears open, keep my heart open. But you cannot trust and believe everything someone tells you. So thanks for watching. We took a picture together. I had me a date in 2022. I went on a date. It's something up with that divorce date. 4 years and 10 years is a big difference. He said, well, I've known her. I didn't ask you how long have you known your ex-wife. I asked you how long have you been divorced. If it's four, why not just say, it's been 4 years. I felt like a boss because I got my car out of the, you know, tow shop, whatever. And I had to ask for his money. I got it out. You know what I'm saying? So, you see, I have money. Whew, boy, y'all, I've been in this car trying to show y'all this tea. Back on the app. Rate, comment, subscribe. Our YouTube love you. Let me know down below what you think. Do you think I'm crazy? I don't think I'm crazy. I am analytical. I look into things. But again, those were some interesting words he used. He jokes when it's time to be serious. I don't mind joking. I don't mind, you know, but I also know when to be serious. And he should too. Bye. So I do want to add to this story that it was really dope that he walked me to my car, number one. It was dope that like he had the flashlight out so I could see that was like a gentleman. It was really dope that he took me to the tow spot. It was South Charlotte, way out the way. He was like, wow, but he did it. He didn't ask for gas money. And in that moment, though, I ain't gonna lie to you, I was thinking, well, you can go and I'll just call my people. Because I always call my father, you know. And he was like, nah, you know, I'll take you. And it was so dope for me because it's hard for me to trust that other people will be there outside of my core, like grandma, aunt, you know. And even though I talk about I want to find a partner one day, a husband, I have a desire for that in a family, the truth is I've never seen myself with someone. And so to have someone by my side that seemed invested, asking like these deep questions about like what's my love language, now that could be his game for all chicks. But I felt like for the first time in a long time, someone was not only talking, but really wanting to invest and see where things could go. And most guys who I talk to, I ain't gonna lie, have been outside of Charlotte. So this guy is in Charlotte. And so, even if we don't work out, because again, I called twice, no call back, but he texting, I'm about to disconnect. But what I will say is this. It felt beautiful. It always feels good to me when I find someone, even if they're far away, but this guy was closer to me, to just feel soft and feminine and just like, oh, he got me, you know? And it felt more tangible. Like in the past, I ain't gonna lie, I feel like what I'm seeking, I feel a pull to it. But I don't see it. And we prayed over our food. Everything was just so cute. And so you see courtship online, you know, Russell and Sierra and Devon and Megan and some other celebrities. But it was just really nice to just kind of like have something forming on my own that I could tell my friends about. Like, wow, 3 weeks for me to talk to a guy. I've talked to guys for like 7 months, but 3 weeks and still feel good, still feel clear is good. And he seemed so like me about communication. I heard what you said. I'm going to adjust. I'm on it. And so I for him, you know, and so was I for him. But I'm a little hurt, but I'm ready to just stop trying. And just move on to someone else that is more clear. Because I don't care how you flip it and reverse it. 4 years is nowhere near 10 years. If I ask you, well, how many months were you pregnant? Because some folks have kids prematurely. If you say, oh, I was only pregnant for like 6 months. That's premature. But if it's really 9 and you said 6, why? Why? If I'm ordering some hair and I want 24 inches, but I get 12 inches, That's a big difference. Numbers matter. Numbers don't lie. People do. Is that what they say? Numbers don't lie. People do. I don't know what they say. I think that's it. But yeah, like, I really like him. But bye. So I made this video on like Thursday or Friday. And I began to just really have it sit in my spirit. He did not contact me on Friday or Saturday. And I began to think, you know what, let me reach out to him. But this time it's not going to be good morning or good evening. I'm going in. So I did create an email already this week, but I made a new one and just really laid everything out. And basically, the goal of this email was to clearly, calmly, but still a little sassy, articulate to him that I did nothing wrong. I asked about your divorce date and you fell back from me. Leads me to believe that you are not divorced from your wife. You're probably separated and didn't know how to tell me. Then I found on his Twitter that all he followed is a bunch of butt-naked hoes. So when you telling me at night you want to disconnect and just like watch educational videos and sports, you probably playing with your pickle. And so I said basically that I wish your car gets old. I wish that hat that you had on, you know, say on our date that was a smiley face turns into a frown. I hope you stomp your big toe or your small toe against your bed. I said, but yeah, again, I wish you well. But yeah, it was a funny. And then I said at the end, like, I'm going to, you know, put on my Toni Braxton wig and just listen to some love songs and heal my heart. He got the message. But I also sent this email to his ex-wife and one of his friends because he said his friend was going through something. Why is your friend coming to you for marital advice when you can't even communicate effectively to a queen in your life? So, yeah, because he ignored me, y'all. Like, I listen, that's my trigger. Do not ignore me. I told him that, and I have been sending emails, and I have been sending smoke signals, audios, you know, all that good stuff, trying to attempt to rebuild and repair and get back to where we were, and I just get a good morning text, and then when I follow up, like, hey, you know, how was your day? Crickets. But I get a good morning text. Nah, he playing with my emotions. This nice guy that I thought was so nice and just a gentleman, possibly a God-fearing man. He has shown me bump you, bump what you stand for. I was just playing. You getting too close to knowing the truth, so I'm going to just let you go. You could have just told me, boo. Say, listen, I really like you. I can tell that you really like me, but I want to be honest with you and say, I am still separated from my wife, but I am not divorced. I'm going to get a divorce in like a couple of years, but not now. Or he could have said, right now, honestly, we have no intentions of getting a divorce. I could have respected that. But I told him that, you know, I do a little investigation on my YouTube channel. And so I'm pretty sure he said, oh, let me fall back. But yeah, you are on the Queen Palace. Bye, y'all. You too. Love you.